Hey parents, has your care provider told you that they think your baby is too big for a vaginal birth and you're feeling nervous about what to do and how to prepare for the birth of your baby? This is often a question or concern mamas bring up to me. So in this video, I'm going to talk to you about when baby is suspected to be too big. I'm Bridget and I'm a childbirth educator and birth doula, and it's my passion to help mamas just like you experience an empowering and informed pregnancy, birth, and postpartum. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and hit the little bell so you don't miss out on any future videos that come your way. For many first-time moms, it's really hard to wrap their mind around a baby being birthed from their body. But to start off this video, I want to encourage you that your body is built to birth and your baby is built to be born. But what do you do when you hear from your care provider that your baby is suspected to be a big baby? Let's dive in and take a look at this. In the last few weeks of pregnancy, you might receive one or a few ultrasounds. If your belly is measuring slightly bigger than expected for your estimated due date, your care provider may do an ultrasound to help determine the size of your baby. The medical term for a big baby is macrosomia, and according to some, is when your baby is 8 pounds 13 ounces or heavier at birth, or to others, 9 pounds 15 ounces or more at birth. So already there's a discrepancy between what is considered a big baby, and it cannot be confirmed until the baby has been born. In a big survey called Listening to Mothers, 2 out of 3 families in the United States had an ultrasound to determine the size of their baby at the end of their pregnancy. 1 in 3 of those families were told their babies were too big, and yet only 1 in 10 babies born is actually considered large. On average, the suspected big babies weighed only 7 pounds 13 ounces. So it's safe to say that there is likely an overdiagnosing of big babies. Using ultrasounds to determine the size of a baby is also pretty unreliable, and many times babies suspected of being large are born under the weight that they are presumed. However, if mama is diabetic or plus size, ultrasounds are usually more accurate in diagnosing large babies than for mothers who are not. When a baby has been diagnosed as large, the usual options parents will get from providers is to either medically induce or plan for a cesarean birth. The concerns that healthcare providers have over a presumed large baby are possible shoulder dystocia, where during birth, baby's shoulders get stuck in the birth canal, causing distress, and the care provider needs to use certain maneuvers to help baby be born, unplanned C-sections, perineal tears, and postpartum hemorrhage. However, all of these concerns, shoulder dystocia, C-section, more severe perineal trauma, and hemorrhaging, are also more likely to happen in an induction over a spontaneous labor, one that begins on its own. Plus, all of those risks are only more likely if the baby truly is a big baby. And as I said before, big babies are likely overdiagnosed. So what about a small pelvis on mama? This is called cephalopelvic disproportion, or CPD for short. And while this can be the case, it's actually pretty rare and quite difficult to accurately diagnose in the first place. Plus, the pelvis can expand 30% more during labor to accommodate baby's head and body, and baby's head actually molds to the shape of the pelvis to be able to fit through. Mama, I'll say it again, you are built to birth and your baby is built to be born. Your body was literally designed with birth in mind. By using movement during labor, avoiding birthing on your back, and learning how to work with your surges to birth your baby, your pelvis and baby work like a key and a lock to unlock the pelvis to be born. I teach you all of this in my Built to Birth course. So even if you're 37 weeks pregnant, taking the Built to Birth course link down below gives you the tools, resources, and information you need to have a happier, healthier, and easier birth, even if your baby is suspected to be too big or your pelvis is said to be too small. It's important to know that induction and C-section are not your only options. You can definitely wait for spontaneous labor and you can attempt a vaginal birth. Especially if this is your first birth, you can't know what your body can do until you try. And if you have given birth before, vaginally or with a C-section, you should still be given the option to try for a vaginal birth. So for parents who feel like they are between a rock and a hard place and perhaps feeling forced to induce or forced to move forward with a C-section, remember that those are not your only options. It's also important to know that once a care provider has diagnosed a large baby, it's common that care providers mothers then manage their labors and births differently. Failure to progress or baby's inability to fit is more likely to be inaccurately diagnosed, which leads to higher C-section rates. Failure to progress is the number one reason for first-time C-sections, and a suspected large baby is the fifth reason for C-sections. So with that in mind, it's important that you and your birth team are informed, you are confident, and you are prepared to advocate for yourself, your baby, and your birth experience, and understand how to facilitate the natural and normal process of birth to unfold. Again, I teach you all of this in the Built to Birth online course, and if you're not ready to commit to the full course, check out the free mini birth class, which I've also linked down below. It is never, ever too late to empower yourself for your birth. If you do decide that a medical induction is the best option for you and your baby, I encourage you to watch my playlist all about the different methods of induction, which I have linked right up here. Parents, I hope if you started out this video feeling nervous and confused, you are now feeling more confident and informed about what your options are. The most important thing you can do is to understand that you have options and claim your rightful authority in making those decisions for yourself, your baby, and your birth experience. A lot of this information in this video is from Evidence-Based Birth, and I've linked her full, very in-depth article about all of this in the description below, as well as the Built to Birth course, which provides you the foundational tools for a better birth. So thanks for being with me in this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, parents.